Today's show is on a very, I would say, cheeky topic. How many times in any city in North India have you seen someone drinking a glass of thandai laced with bhang? How many times have you seen that person being arrested? There is a very thin line in India as far as bhang, which is one of the forms of marijuana or cannabis, is concerned, simply because this whole concept of bhang or charas is ingrained in the Indian culture for so many centuries. Today, we are asking the question, should India legalize marijuana? Take a look. How many times have you wanted to soar to heights? Not in an airplane or parachute, but on dope. Well, marijuana and its various forms has been used since the 3rd millennium BC as a recreational or medicinal drug or as part of religious rites. Currently illegal in most parts of the world, Uruguay recently became the first country to legalize and control the trade of the psychoactive drug as a way of battling the black market economy. In India, marijuana has been known to be used by Lord Shiva himself. It even inspired singer Papon to compose the song Banao Banao. Right now. Well, veteran actor Nasiruddin Shah has confessed that he did a lot of this banaoing as a young man. People who favor its use say it is less harmful than alcohol or tobacco, though it does have long-term effect on the brain. So the question we are asking is, should India too legalize and regulate pot? You're aware we are raising a very, very pertinent question as far as many of us go. What would be your first reaction to what we are saying? Uruguay has done it first. The whole world is watching. Lots of positive and negative reactions. What do you think India should do? Should India legalize marijuana?
See, during Holi, it's like marijuana, the usage of marijuana is deeply ingrained in our culture,
right?
And our religion, our tradition. Even during Shivratri, there is mass usage and sale and consumption of marijuana in the temples. Even during Holi, it's like a family affair, you
Absolutely.
Know, like you were saying, and even Abhilash said, all the kind of pakoras and foods and
thandai.
So my thing is, it's about the hypocritical society we are living in. If you know, those 2 days everything is fine, why is marijuana looked down upon, you know, for the rest of the days in the year in India, you know? So the thing is, you say that cigarette smoking is injurious to health, and of course there are numbers which will show you that it kills people.
Yes.
Even alcohol. But you know, when you enter into any movie hall or something, you know, there is this whole awareness program that, you know, smoking is injurious and you will die and this and that. So it's like a kind, if that is the case, I'm not saying ban it, but why not ban it? If you're promoting that it is dangerous for your health, and at the same time, you know, you are going forward with the sale of it. Even same thing with alcohol.
Hmm.
But what is the problem with marijuana? I'm not kidding.
I also have with me Abhilash. Abhilash is a filmmaker who has made a documentary on legalization of marijuana, and he joins us on the phone line as he is traveling. Abhilash Sahu, welcome to India Post Live.
Hi.
Abhilash, your take on legalization of marijuana as far as India is concerned?
So the point is, marijuana was always sort of legal in India any which ways till 1985. And post that, in the Rajiv Gandhi government during that time, the NDPS Act was passed. So it's not that India is a country where marijuana and the consumption of marijuana is taboo or anything.
Hmm.
How I see is it in two ways. One is economical and one is social.
Right.
Economically, I think the amount of tax revenue which can be generated by the sales of marijuana and probably charas, hashish, any of that, by the government itself, can raise a lot of amount of money, and I think that can directly go into like welfare of things which government can't do right now. On the social front, I think it's like already people are consuming marijuana. It's not that
exactly.
It's not there in the society.
Hmm.
So and everybody always has the option to choose to do it or not to do it. So this question should not be, you know, like mixed with the question of legalizing marijuana or not. What I think is it should be legalized because countries now such as America and Uruguay have already taken the initiative, and marijuana also being, you know, like one of the native plants of India itself.
Yes.
And in our Vedic, in our Vedas, the five sacred plants, one of them is bhang.
Yes.
So so it's like we are just getting back to our roots.
We also have some more responses. We have Meher Oberoi. Meher Oberoi from Chandigarh. She tells us what her views are on legalization of marijuana. Take a look.
As a college student, I can tell you that just because it's not legal, it's not like people are not doing it. Like, the fact that it's not legal is not keeping people from doing it. And because of that, they have to go through all these, go through meeting all these back alley dealers. And it's a shady environment. It's not very safe. There's no quality control over the drug. So legalization will do away with all of that. And other than that, it's not much more harmful than alcohol is. It's not much more harmful than cigarettes are. So I don't know why it's illegal in the first place. And other than that, medically, I think it needs to be studied and researched more, because if it can, well, they're saying they might find a cure for cancer through it. And it's already been used for treatment of glaucoma, but if they can find a cure for cancer through it, that's a wonderful thing.
Another video feedback that we got from Ria Bhatia. Ria is from Delhi, and this is what she had to say about her thoughts on the issue.
If you consume medicine also in a huge quantity, that will also have negative impact. So this is marijuana. It is, even though it is a sacred plant, but everything has its goods and odds. Thus, I feel it should totally be legalized. And talking about it from the economic point of view, if we legalize it, the money that we generate out of it can be used to help other sectors that need monetary help. That's why I feel that it should totally be legalized. Otherwise, I think we should illegalize smoking, cigarette smoking, and alcohol as well. Because if marijuana can cause destruction, then I think the other two can totally are actually causing discussion. Thank you.
All right, so that was Ria Bhatia telling us why she thinks it should be legalized, and she also thinks it should be legalized. So generally on this show, we've had a consensus, and that doesn't happen too often, I can tell you that. All right, it's time to wrap up the show. Shayan Ganguly, thank you so much for joining us with your comments.
I'd like to know, you know, since you don't smoke up, what do you feel about the thing? Because all the people who have come, they have spoken for it. But
yeah.
Since you belong to the other, you know, like you don't know about it, so what is your perception? Can you please share it?
It would be professionally wrong for me to air my personal thoughts on this matter, but I can say that I would love to and go for a drive with you someday.
Yeah, I can hear the hoots behind.